what I look for all of them to be technically proficient in whatever that piece is, whether it's the analysis piece or the security piece or the cyberspace operations piece, right? So I want them to be technically proficient. But more importantly, I want them to be creative thinkers. This is a wide-ranging area where we need folks to think more outside the box, be creative, think about things that other people haven't thought about yet, right? So push their limits on how they think creatively. Really need to understand networks and computer science. And I say that because, and I put the two together, because most networks are now based on small computers anyway. Looking and hiring more folks that do have sociology degrees, maybe as their bachelor's, and then go in and get a computer science as a master's, because that's a great combination to understand first how society and humans interact, and then, oh, by the way, how do humans interact with computers? I highly encourage folks to have some sort of an interest that's not just related to, like if you're an engineer, it shouldn't just be some sort of engineering challenge. If you're a computer science, it shouldn't just be on the computer again. Find something else that's a little different and challenges a different part of your brain to think differently and stretch and see where you go. Most of the folks I've seen do really, really well in the science area are also very good musicians, which I think is an interesting balance. There are more and more scholarships every year available for in the STEM area specifically, and if you drill it down even more so into the computer science and cyber areas. There are a lot of nonprofit organizations out there, from AFSEA to AUSA to the Air Force Association, that are offering scholarships in the cyber area. The National Science Foundation has one of the best in the country, supported by more universities than probably any other one. Not all businesses pay internships. I will tell you the federal government always pays internships. That's a great way to get your security clearance started. Because as a student and you get that secret put in for, then by the time you graduate, you can work in all those government programs with us.